Hi, and welcome. We at 365 Data Science specialize in data science trainings. We post videos weekly, so you can master indispensable skills for free. All right, let's get started.
This is going to be a short lecture explaining factorials. The notion n factorial is used to express the product of the natural numbers from 1 to n. This means that n factorial equals 1 times 2 times 3 all the way up to n. For instance, 3 factorial is equal to 6, since 1 times 2 times 3 equals 6. Simple enough, right? For the remainder of the lecture, we are going to explain some important properties of factorial mathematics. Before we get into the more complicated concepts, you should know that there is one odd characteristic. Negative numbers don't have a factorial, and 0 factorial is equal to 1 by definition. All right, let's explore the first property. For any natural number n, we know that n factorial equals n minus 1 factorial times n. Similarly, n plus 1 factorial equals n factorial times n plus 1. For example, 6 factorial equals 5 factorial times 6. In the same way, 7 factorial equals 6 factorial times 7. This notion can be expanded further to express n plus k factorial and n minus k factorial. In mathematical terms, this is equivalent to n plus k factorial equals n factorial times n plus 1 times n plus 2, and so on, up to n plus k. Similarly, n minus k factorial equals n factorial over n minus k plus 1 times n minus k plus 2 all the way up to n minus k plus k, which equals n. For instance, if n is 5 and k is 2, then 5 plus 2 factorial equals 7 factorial, or 5 factorial times 6 times 7, and also 5 minus 2 factorial equals 3 factorial, or 5 factorial over 4 times 5. Okay, great. An important observation is that if we have two natural numbers, k and n, where n is the greater number, then n factorial over k factorial equals k plus 1 times k plus 2 all the way up to n. Let's look at an example where n is 7 and k is 4. Then 7 factorial over 4 factorial equals the product of the numbers between 1 and 7 over the product of the numbers between 1 and 4. We can simplify this by crossing out 1, 2, 3, and 4, since they occur in both parts of the fraction. Doing so leaves us with 5 times 6 times 7. Great. Now you have the tools that will allow you to handle factorial operations.
If you found this video interesting and want to gain an edge in your career, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to check out some of our other videos for another quick win in the data science skills department.